Hello everyone, welcome to Code and Learn. In this video, we are going to look at LeetCode problem 3, finding the longest substring without repeating characters in a given string. Let's go over the problem statement first. Given a string S, find the length of longest substring without repeating characters. So, we will be given a string which has repeating characters, and we need to find the longest substring which has non-repeating characters. The first example we have is ABCA, BC, BB. So you can see A, B, C all are repeating characters in this. And we need to find the longest substring with non-repeating characters, which is ABC in this case. In the next example, we have BB, BB, B. In this case, the longest substring with non-repeating characters is the character B itself, or a substring with only character B and length of 1. Similarly, in the third example, we have PWW, KEW. In this case, the longest substring without repeating character is WKE. The constraints of the problem state, the string consists of English letter, digit, symbols, and spaces. Now let's visualize the solution first before going into the code. So we are going to take the example of ABC, ABC, D. So to find a solution to this problem, we are going to use a sliding window. We will have two pointers, start and end. Start is the start of the window, while E represents the end of the window. Along with the start and end, we will have two variables to store the max length of non-repeating substring, and then a map to store what characters we have already seen. This will make sure that the character we are currently on is the one that we haven't seen before. We will calculate the length with the formula end minus start plus 1. That will give you the length of the current window. In this case, since both are 0, the max length will be 1. As such, we will update the max to 1. Along with that, we will also store the character that we have seen with the index. So, we have seen A at 0. Then, we move the end of the sliding window to the next character, that is B in our case. The first thing we do is use the map to check if we have seen B already. In this case, there's no B in our map, so we can calculate the new length of the window. The new length of the window will be 2, which is greater than max, so we will update it. Next, we will repeat the same step again, that is, move E to the next. Before doing that, we need to add B to our map to keep a track of the last seen index. In this case, B is at index 1. At C, the first thing we do is check if we have seen C already. Since it does not exist in the map, we can calculate the new length of the substring, which is 3 in our case, as such, greater than max that we currently hold. So we will update the max value and say the current max is 3. Now we create an entry for C in our map and say that we have seen C at index 2. Next, we move E to the next character. The first thing we do is to check if A exists in our map, which it does. So in case where a character already exists in our map, we will move S to the next index, that is index right of A. So S is now here. Again, we calculate the length of the substring, which is in this case is 3. Since it is same as the max length, we don't update it. But in this case, we will update the index of the character A, since it already exists in our map. A now holds 4. Now let's move the end of our window to B. Again, do the same thing and check if B already exists in our map. Since B already exists, we will repeat the same thing, that is moving S to index of B plus 1, which is here. Now perform the calculation for the window, or the current length of the window, which is 3, same as the max length, so we don't update it. But we do update the index of B in our map that we have. So we say the last B we have seen is at index 5. Next, we move the end of the window to C. Then we check again if C already exists in our map, which it does. So what we will do is move S to C plus 1, which is at A. Update the index of character C in our map to 6. And then calculate the length of the current window, which is 3 again. As such, we don't update the max length. Now we move our end of the window to D. We check if D already exists in our map, which it doesn't. So we update the value of D to say that D exists at index 7. Calculate the length of the window, which in this case is 4. So since it's greater than the max, we will update max. Since end of the window has reached the end of the string, we can say the max length of non-repeating substring is 4, which in this case is A, B, C, and D. So that's how the sliding window approach will be used to solve this problem. Since we only iterate over the string once, the time complexity of this solution is O, N, where N is equal to the number of characters in the string. Additionally, we also have a space complexity, since we are using a map to store the indices of characters that we encounter. So, the space complexity of this solution will be O of N as well, because in the worst case, we will have to store all the characters in the string. Now, let us go to our code to understand how we solve it with our Go program. First, I am going to create a function called length of the longest substring, which takes a string and returns an integer, which is the length of the longest substring without repeating characters. Inside it, let's create a map to keep tabs of the character and their indices. I can say char map, create a map of rune and int values. If you remember, we are using rune because it represents a Unicode code point. Next, let us initiate the start of the window and the max length variable used to store the length of the longest non-repeating substring. So, start of the window and the max length is 0. Next, let us write our loop for our sliding window. So here, end is the index of the current character and character is the current character in the string that we are on. First thing we do is, we will check if the current character exists in our map. So here, we are saying if the current character is found in the map and the current character is on the right side of the start of the window, we will update the start to index plus 1. Next, let us check if the length of the window is greater than the max length. If that is the case, we will update the max length. So we can say current length of the window is end minus start plus 1. If current length is greater than the max length, we will update the max length. Then we will also update the last seen index of the current character, which is 10. At the end of the loop, we return the max length. So this is the solution for this problem using sliding window. Let's go over the solution again. First, we created a char map. Char map stores the last index of where the character was last seen. Next, we created start and max length. Start is the start of the window and max length is the length of the longest non-repeating substrings we have seen till now. Then we start a for loop to iterate over the string. We check if the character is already in the char map. If found and the index is greater than or equal to the start, it means the character repeats within the current window. So, we update the start to the next index after the previous occurrence of the character. Next, we calculate the current length of the window, and if it's greater than the current max length, we update the current max length. At the end of each iteration, we update the char map with the index of the current character. After the execution of loop, max length will be the length of the longest non-repeating substring. That's it for the solution. I hope you enjoyed it. Please feel free to ask any questions you may have by posting a comment under the video or reaching out to our Discord server. Until next time, happy coding!